Shalom Aleichem, Shalom Aleichem.
My name is Lisa, Rausch worker. I live in San Jose, California. I'm married, and my wife and I live in our little humble hobbit hole.
Malachi Elyon.
I didn't always bake challah. I used to buy it when I lived in LA, and I was just out of college. I used to go to the bakery every week. But as my grandparents, I used to have grandparents who were bakers. I think I grew up appreciating all of this homemade stuff, and my mom used to make challah when I was growing up. But as I got older and my grandma got older, we wanted to document how she made challah because she was starting to lose her memory. So at a certain point when I was in college, my parents videotaped my grandma. They made a videotape of her on her birthday making challah in her special, and she braided it in this special way, that using 6 braids instead of 3. They gave me this a copy of this videotape, and I learned how to make the recipe that I make today from that videotape. Even though she would get stuck and stop, and my mom would have to help her get back on track, you know, her brain wasn't remembering, but her hands remembered how to do it. So from that point, I started experimenting, and I asked for her recipe, but she didn't have the recipe anymore. But my great aunt, who she used to make challah with in South America, had the recipe. So I went to my great aunt to get this recipe, and she hands me this torn, stained, transparent, ripped piece of kind of waxy paper with this typewritten recipe on it that was missing half the steps. So I had to go home and kind of recreate it and experiment with, and then I added a little bit of my own stuff. Anyway, so I came up with what I thought was pretty close to what her recipe was, and I started making challah every week. I think part of the love of it, one, it's total therapy. I call it challah therapy. When you're kneading the dough, you can get out all your aggressions physically. But it ties me to my grandparents. And because they had to leave Czechoslovakia before Hitler came in, and then they spent a few years, very difficult years, in South America on a farm, and then they came here. They had a very hard life, and it's just, I was very lucky to have a relationship with them, but I never got to learn directly from them how to bake. I was too young or not interested at the time when they were living to get the benefit of their tutelage one-on-one. So after they died, I really felt like this was my connection to them, was the cooking and the baking. And so making challah every week makes me feel closer to my grandparents and their story. And if they hadn't left, I wouldn't be here. I know for a fact that there are people who I have taught how to make it, and every week they make challah and they bring it to their elderly parents, or they bring it to friends, and they've taught people. So I feel like even though I don't have children, I've passed this tradition along, and there are people out there who are continuing it, which is really nice.
HaKadosh Baruch Hu.